That's right. So there's no better treasure hunt opportunity than to find something that is less than desirable in condition, but still worth a lot of money. I had made a video a few days ago regarding a 1983 Lincoln cent that was struck on a copper planchet, a bronze planchet, that sold for many thousands of dollars. And one particular listener said, "You know what? This is what I like. I want to see beat up circulated coins that sell for a lot of money." Well, this one's for Audrey. Thank you for pointing that out. And I have a truly marvelous example of a coin that, well, it didn't sell for thousands of dollars, but how does $420 sound like? That's quite a bit of money for what would be this coin that you see on screen. It's a 1989p. It's a Philadelphia minted Roosevelt dime that apparently has a little bit of die clashing going on, as you can see from this photo. This is what we strive for when we're searching those bank rolls and pocket change, and this is the real reason why you search it. Okay, you don't search it for the mega mint state 68 2000, Lincoln cent that sells for 5 grand. Okay, the odds of that happening aren't nearly as good as finding, say, something like this or that 83 Lincoln cent transitional coin. These are the kind of like the low key type of finds that we strive to look for. Okay, so this is one example, and that sold just a few days ago. If I remember correctly, it sold on the 27th through a traditional auction format on eBay. And this is, again, a 1989 10 cent Roosevelt dime with some pretty spectacular clashing. All right, so here are some close-ups of the obverse of the coin with the clashing. As you could see, you could identify the olive sprigs and some of the torch details. Some of the lettering is apparent on this coin, which is really nice. The more clashing characteristics that show up on these type of coins, the more they're worth. Okay, as you could tell, $420 for a circulated 1989 dime just seems a little bit far-fetched, but when you have something significant that's attached to it, that's where you see all the money comes in for something like this. I've seen coins like this sell for $100, $200, but this one is significant enough because of one reason. The clashing is especially heavy on both sides of the coin. Furthermore, if you looked at these close-ups of the front of the coin, details of the clashing, there's even clashing on the bridge of Roosevelt's nose, where you know that these dies hit hard when there was no planchet made available to be struck. Okay, that's how clashing starts. You have the obverse impression smacking up against the reverse impression of the dies, and there you go. You get something pretty spectacular. So on the reverse of the coin, again, just as stunning, you have more of the profile line of Roosevelt's bust on this one, which, it's pretty strong. Plus, you also have what appears to be the P, the letter P in the mint mark of Philadelphia, right above the date on this one, also plain evident right on the coin. So when you take just some ordinary regular run-of-the-mill date coin that traditionally we would normally pass up, and you add some pretty significant die clashing to it, you get a coin that's worth many hundreds of dollars. So, Audrey, again, thank you for the great comment. Because of that, I found you another good one. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, I'm your host, Blue Ridge Silverhound. Feel free to subscribe, and I do have Facebook. Come join me at Blue Ridge Silverhound. It's 4 words. Come by, say hi. Best way to support me, of course, is to like both the video and my page. And as always, appreciate your guys' time. Love you. And yeah, keep on hunting for them cool varieties and rarities. I'll talk to you guys soon. Have a great day.